the real life. Well, I underestimated the fear these freaks could instill in others. We didn't realize how much weight calling you a racist could bear on them. They picked handcuffs of Michael Moore sitting on a newborn baby's chest for 45 minutes. And we underestimated how many cowards would cave in to this form of domestic terrorism. That's right, canceling people's lives because of something you said is terrorism, not raising your voice with school boards and jackasses. So, unlike the summer love, the left today didn't turn on, tune in, and drop out. They applied for jobs at big companies and got them. Netflix, Twitter, Disney World, even my masseuse has four pronouns. I never knew them. Everywhere that you see decline in freedom or fun, there they are. They even ruined Star Wars. I know that. It reminds North Korean defectors of home. They now target stuff that was off-limits, your parenting abilities, your health, your job, your safety. You know, things that used to come under the category of none of your business. And everything you say is now a tripwire. I say booby trap, but I don't want to get involved in this HR. This isn't feeling like America. Maybe that's the goal. They never liked this place to begin with, but instead of leaving, they're trying to recreate what immigrants escape from. Tyranny, authoritarianism, fascism. They focus on bureaucrats, media powers, and power, and replace them with little tyrants dedicated to the left-wing hive mind. And now hate speech is all speech except theirs. It's weird to see a free press embrace this. It's like surgeons disavowing the Hippocratic Oath. It's like athletes denouncing winning. It's like me condemning sculpted texts. So they chose the worst position because they aren't yours, and condemn things only because you might be for them. This happens when you make the political personal. They go after cops, moms, dads, kids. Now, what could be next? You can say a lot about these leftist a-holes, but unambitious.